Stand up, please. Veterans, stand up, and your families. Veterans and your families. Let's give a cheer and a round of applause. Thank you. Veterans of Foreign War, Post 334, Color Guard, Captain Marpetti, Post the Colors. Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
To our honored military veterans and our military men and women who are now serving, to our honored military dead who made the supreme sacrifice for our country, our municipal officials, especially to our Orion supervisor, Chris Barnett, and the Orion Board of Trustees, to the Board of Directors, and our many benefactors of the Orion War Memorial, also called Orion Veterans Memorial, to our volunteers, especially to Park Manager Bob Watrous, who keeps our beautiful memorial both summer and winter. Families, friends of our community, and fellow American patriots. This morning, we gather together to commemorate Veterans Day. Today is the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, the same time and date as it was in 1919 when the armistice of World War I was signed, known as the Treaty of Versailles. This supposedly was the war to end all wars, according to President Woodrow Wilson. World peace was thought to be just around the corner, only to be deceived mightily by World War II. Today, people throughout the country will gather together, just like us, to remember, to honor, and to pay tribute to veterans who have served our country. Our gathering here this morning is one small spark in the flame of pride that burns across our nation today. It is not a lot, but is one small way we can honor those who have sacrificed so we may live in freedom. Across our nation and throughout our history, people of common background and uncommon courage have put their lives on the line in defense of our nation. And time again, these brave men and women have come home only to continue serving in our schools, churches, elected offices, and civic organizations. I am struck not only by their profound patriotism of our veterans, but by their deep humility and lasting dedication to serving others, and by so doing, continue serving our country. May God bless us with world peace. May God bless our veterans. And may God continue to bless our United States of America. Our chaplain will now deliver our invocation.
Please stand. Let us remember that there are men and women far from their families and comforts of home today, missing hugs and kisses, birthday parties, and baseball games, praying for a safe return to the country and the people they love. These are United States soldiers and sailors. Some are our brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, parents, neighbors, classmates, and friends. Others we have never met, but they risk their lives daily for our freedom. Will you join us in lifting up these troops and their families? We may honor them on specific days, but their service makes a difference in our lives every day. Please uncover. Dear Lord, our hearts are filled with gratitude for the men and women who serve our country and for the sacrifices their families make so that we can all enjoy the blessings of freedom. We praise you for calling them to help protect us and for giving them the courage and ability to do their jobs well. Guide their choices and their actions, Lord. Help them to see you working in their daily lives, whether in the field, at home, or abroad. Surround them with your mighty angels. Protect them in your mercy. Cover them with your grace. Guard their hearts while they are far from loved ones. Bless them with moments to cherish when they are together. Hold these families close, Lord. May they look to you for the strength and peace that only you can give. Amen. Cover.
Please remain standing for the Star Spangled Banner, conducted by the North Oakland Patriotic Band, conductor Annette Klein. Annette.
Johnson.
Seated. Jim Hubbard, VFW Post 334, will deliver our main address. Jim?
We have a speaker for that. Just would like to welcome everybody here today. Here, and we're very happy to serve this community. You served a military. Take advantage of what you've earned. I know that there's some getting better care. Officers to help you go through all the paperwork. Take time. Join one of the organizations. Almost all of those organizations have auxiliaries. You know, ladies can get involved with your husbands and doing support veterans and veterans houses. We're all here to make our lives easier and better. We're only here for a short time. As we get older, I really do, but those, while we're here, we need to honor them, and I really do appreciate being the post commander of Post 334. We're out here doing our very best in the community. If there's anything that anybody needs or wants or you'd like to join, please get a hold of me or our service officer. Become a part of something that's good. We really do appreciate are doing our very best to do. Lisa said,
make a list of all the things you do. And I have it in my pocket. There's like 30 things that we just do locally. You know,
Buddy Poppies comes to my mind. But one of our
things I thought I should make you
aware of is the National Home for Children. We don't want to call
them orphans, but they are orphans.
They're at the National Home for Children. We have 144 children there now. We're supporting
them, educate them right through college.
All paid for by veterans.
It's something that we're very proud of doing.
Make sure every service that we have together that we have prayers, honor those orphans and widows. Our main purpose is to help veterans, widows and orphans, and to make sure that they have a better life. But just wanted to
spend a moment with this.
join one of your service organizations and take part of the community. Thank you very much.
Annette. North Oakland Band will now perform. Annette.
You want me to tell them what we're doing?
Yeah. We're going to play Armed Forces on Parade. And when you hear your service song, if you're Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, or Coast Guard, please stand when you hear your service song played. Thank you.
You can sing along if you want.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you, North Oakland Patriotic Band conductor Annette Klein. Beautiful. Joseph Jamil is our guest speaker, and Joseph is the president and founder of Project Brotherhood Resolve. Joseph.
Good morning, everybody. Can everybody hear me? Even without the mic? Just checking. I would like to thank Captain Master Mateo for inviting me to speak today. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Veterans, spouses, present, past, and future. I was told I have 10 minutes, so I try to come up with a speech for 10 minutes. I did a lot of research. I went on YouTube, looked at different speeches that have been done before. Every speech that I have found has always included a quotation from a previous president or a general or an admiral. I figured I would take my speech in a different direction this year. There's a pandemic that we have among veterans here in the United States that is somewhat of a taboo to speak about. And I will be speaking about that to everybody, because today we celebrate Veterans Day on this 11th day, or the 11th month, the 11th hour. However, on average, 22 veterans today may commit suicide. How many of us were aware of that fact? These are veterans, we are all veterans, and the military teaches us one thing, is to hold it in. In the words of every drill sergeant, non-commissioned officer, and officer that I served under, suck it up, buttercup, move on. We've all heard words of that nature at one point or another in our careers. So we are taught to suck it up and move on. We are never taught to go and take care of ourselves. We are never taught to go and seek the help that we need. And therefore, when we walk the line at the very edge of our life, instead of seeking help, most of the time it is the unfortunate decision that we make to end our lives. I personally have had three persons that I have known take their life. I had the last one, unfortunately, survived the attempt. I was at his bonfire last night, joking and drinking. Hopefully, next time he feels that way, he'll know that there's plenty of us out here that he can reach out to. Sitting in my VFW at Post 4139 in Lapeer amongst veterans of World War II, Vietnam, North Korea, Lebanon, Desert Storm, Iraq, and Afghanistan, you could see that all veterans suffer from this choice. Some of us make this choice on a daily basis of whether to stay alive or whether to end it all. The only quote that I will inflict upon you this day is a quote that I've heard from many persons, and I cannot alienate who said it. But suicide is a permanent solution to a temporary problem. I ride the roller coaster of life every day, financially, mentally, and physically. I have my ups and I have my downs, and I've had the moment or two where I was on the edge. The feeling of sitting in a car parked 20 feet away from my house with my loaded gun to my head is unexplainable. The only thing that saved me was God, because he had his best angels fighting on my side when I was at the edge of life. I asked myself one question before I put my finger on the trigger, is why am I doing this? And I did not have a good reason of why to actually put my finger on the trigger. My gun went back down and the tears came out, and I did not walk back into my house until I was back to normal. That is my story. Others have unfortunate endings. Some have fortunate endings. But we as veterans, we have a duty and a responsibility to our fellow brothers and sisters. Make sure that we are reaching out to everybody. Because one of the veterans that I know that committed suicide was smiling and laughing, and he was financially well, and his family was doing good. But unfortunately, inside of him was where the darkness was, not on the outside. It is said that people who are constantly depressed put on the best face out in public. They smile more often. They often seem more happier than everybody else around them. But in real life, they are the ones that are hiding in the corner of life, trying to figure it out and not reaching out and asking for help. That is one thing that I have personally learned over the last couple of years, is that if I want the help, I'm the one that needs to go get the help. If I want the resources, I need to research the resources. The VA has been improving, but there are plenty of veteran organizations out there that have been started over the course of the last 10 years especially, that are out there to help you. We've all been through the VA system, and honestly, I'm one of them that doesn't really trust the VA system. But it's a source that I have and I go to. There are plenty of veterans that are homeless because of their conditions. They go to the VA, the VA gives them the same medication and the same stuff over and over and over. Is that the right answer? To me, it wasn't. I walked into the VA hospital my first time, and I went to the behavioral health, and I told him all my problems. And he told me, you have PTSD. And then he proceeded to ask me the million-dollar question. Do you own firearms? Why, yes, I do, sir. Plenty of them. Who do you live with? I live by myself. My family's in Chicago. Well, I am going to prescribe you 3 pills, and their side effects are depression, suicide, and everything else that I came in for treatment. So I just got done telling this person with a PhD in psychology that I have suicidal thoughts, and the medication he wants to give me may cause me more suicide. Awesome. I'll just go back to the Army medic, take an 800 millimeter Motrin and some water, and I'll be a lot better than that. He proceeded to give me the medication. I never took a dose of it. I've seen a lot of people. I've been around a lot of vets that have taken the meds, and all I keep seeing is they keep going back to the same problem over and over and over. I figured that is not the right answer. That is apparently the only answer that the VA has to anybody with mental behavior health. Is they pop pills. Pills aren't always the answer. I've noticed one thing from my 3 deployments after I came back every time is I kept losing interest in a lot of the hobbies that I have. I came back from my 2nd deployment and I bought myself a sports bike, which my parents weren't really happy about. Motorcycle. And I used to zoom all around the place, and that was my adrenaline rush coming back from my deployment. And I spent countless of hours working on that motorcycle. I learned how to change the clutch. I learned how to do many things on it. But then after I came back from Afghanistan, my 3rd tour, I lost a lot of that interest. I don't spend as much time with my baby as much as I used to before. So I figured that I need to put myself in a position where I don't think as much of the bad in life, and I actually do something for the good. So I tore up my basement, because I wanted to learn how to do drywall and electric and all that fun stuff. That was 3 years ago, and I'm still working on my basement. It just needs a paint job and a floor, and it'll be done. But in the process, I reran the wires. My uncle, who's an electrician, came up and made sure I'm not going to burn the house down. Awesome. I put up drywall. I did a pretty decent job at that. I painted and I did some funky stuff in the basement that nobody's ever done before. I actually put lattice for a ceiling. Everybody here knows lattice goes outside, not inside. But it looks pretty, so I left it. I went down to Kuwait for 6 months for my civilian job. And at the post that I was there, they had a wood shop. It was free for everybody. So I took it upon myself to learn how to be a woodworker. And the first thing and pretty much the only thing I ever did was build flat cases. I built small flat cases. I've built big flat cases. I've even built one for the Chicago Cubs. And some of you guys are going to frown upon this, but I am from Chicago. That explains it all, right? I was in Kuwait during the World Series, and I happened to sneak in a flag for the Game 7 that was presented to them. I built the flat case myself. I've also built flat cases for supporters of Project Brotherhood Resolve, previous workers that I have worked with. And that got me interested in woodworking. So I went to Harbor Freight, and everybody here knows never go to Harbor Freight. But I'm broke, and that's what I can afford. So I went to Harbor Freight. I bought me some table saws, some miter saws, and some other funky tools. And I started woodworking. And I do some more flat cases, and I'm trying to build my bed because I don't want to go out and spend the $200 to build it or to buy it, so I want to build it myself. But all the stuff is what I'm getting to is I'm keeping myself preoccupied from the thought of I have a depressed mind. I'm keeping my brain active, and it's something that I like. I do enjoy shooting still, and that relaxes me a lot. And it's something that I saw on a Facebook post during the 4th of July that said, and I don't mean to offend anybody by this, specifically combat vets. And the post said, I am disappointed in all combat vets who run and hide during a fireworks show. You are combat vets. You have seen more than this. Get your wallet together. Go buy an arsenal of this and show them what a real fireworks show is. There's a truth to that. We keep hiding because we keep remembering, which is not bad. I'm not telling you not to remember. But the point of the post is that when you come out and you put on the bigger fireworks show, you actually come out and you're telling them, this is what it really is. In July of 2000, 2 years ago, as I'm backtracking, I decided to pool some money with my cousins and we bought about $2,000 worth of fireworks. Took us 10 minutes to get rid of it, and nobody else in the neighborhood fired up one shot until we were done because we showed them what a fireworks show was. So next time you hear a backfire, next time you're out there in the 4th of July, don't hide. Go out there and face your fears, because the only way you're going to get through life is if you face your fears. Plenty of us vets come back with a different mentality. All of us do. We need to adjust ourselves to that mentality. We need to make sure that we work with it, not against it. You don't swim against the current, you swim with the current, and then you get out of the trouble that you're in. Keep swimming with the current, you're going to drown. If you let your demons win, then you fail. It is your job to live. This is the longer fight that nobody tells you about when you come back from war. Join the military, you go through basic training, and they teach you how to take lives. They teach you the many ways of how to take lives and the ways to do it. You go to war and you do what you were supposed to do. You serve your country, and then you come back home, and nobody tells you that you left the battle. Welcome to the real war, and the real war is you. It is your mind. That is the war. That is the war that makes 15,000 homeless veterans on a daily basis out in the United States. That is the war that an average of 22 veterans commit suicide every day. Some of our demons are worse than others, I understand. But the Bible says that God doesn't give you more than what you can handle. And if you think about it, we as human beings can accomplish miracles. Who knew that we can climb the coldest mountain in the world? Who knew that a 19-year-old can stand up to a German barrage and win the fight all by himself on a burning tank? Who knew that somebody can fall 22,000 feet from his turret and end up alive? 22,000 feet. 4 miles, falling at 200 miles an hour. That is a pancake waiting to happen. Not one broken bone. We are made to accomplish great things. We have to believe it. We have to live it. And we have to get up and do it. That is why I started Project Brotherhood Resolve. I started it because it's our duty to take care of our brothers and sisters when our system fails to take care of them. My goal is to house every homeless veteran that we can, long term and not short term. But the idea is I need your help doing it. Because we tried the government way, and it's not working. We have to try it our way. And we owe it to our brothers and sisters to do so. So I leave you with this. When you're feeling down, call somebody. It's not hard. Get on Facebook. I've actually helped 3 different veterans off of Facebook that I did not know. One of them when I was in Kuwait. Just because somebody posted that I'm feeling really, really bad and I'm about to do it. Why? Reach out. Get the help you need. It might not be from the VA. It might be from the person at the VFW sitting next to you. This is for the younger generations. You will be amazed at what the older generations sitting next to you have survived. We fought our war with technology. They fought their wars in trenches and face to face. Talking about some badass people. Talk to them. Find out their stories. Ask yourself, why am I doing this? And then if you cannot come up with a good reason to not do it, then ask yourself, how's everybody else around me going to feel? Because it might be your permanent solution to your temporary problem. But in the end, it's a permanent problem for your temporary solution for the people around you. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate your time.
Thank you, Joe, for a wonderful acknowledgement of what we can do in this room for our brotherhood. Let us now have a moment of silence in honor of those veterans in our area who have passed away. Lauren Raymond, Jack Simmons, Ray Korluski, Mike Flower, Fowler, Ronald Finley, Bruce Williams, Al McWayne, Bernard Kipscrew, Mike Hardy, Dale Allen, Jerry Daniels, Harry Somerville, Fred Lizziness, and Carl Danielson. We'll take a moment of reflection. With the auxiliary of VFW Post 334, Kathy Hubbard, Tony Watrous, and Janine Stetson, please place the wreath and flags. The North Oakland Patriotic Band will perform America the Beautiful. Everybody sing in, please.
Thank you.
Janine Stetson of Auxiliary of Veterans Foreign War Post 334 will deliver our closing prayer. Janine.
Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for the privilege of being able to gather once more to express appreciation to our veterans who throughout history have left home and family and sacrificed for the greater good of mankind. Sacrifice is something you, Lord, could identify with more so than any other. Because of the armed services' combined efforts and unselfish love of country, we have been able to enjoy many freedoms and live in peace and safety. Thank you for blessing our country, and please continue to protect us with the many new threats we're facing. We give special recognition to the brave men and women who either paid the ultimate price or returned from combat with physical and emotional wounds. Please help them and their families to receive the treatments they deserve and require to have their dignity, health, and stability restored as much as possible, and bless them with your comfort and hope. For those who are currently defending our shores and our freedoms, we ask that you would protect them as they are protecting us even now, and grant them your peace as they pursue the dream of lasting peace among nations. We entrust them to you and ask you to provide for their needs, remove obstacles that would hinder their well-being, and sustain those who await in anticipation of their safe return from harm's way. We give thanks to all our veterans, past, present, and future, whatever their contribution, for service, courage, and commitment to freedom. May we always treat them with gratitude and respect and keep them in our prayers. The benefits we have because of those who have fought for us need to be shared at every opportunity so that our future generations will understand and appreciate the fact that freedom comes at a very dear cost. Finally, we remember those who are prisoners of war or missing in action and still have a chance of beating the odds. We pray that this would be the case for them. Now, as we go our separate ways, grant us traveling mercies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
please remain standing for the gun salute. Color guard, please retire the colors. Remain standing. North Oakland Patriotic Band will perform God Bless America to conclude our ceremony. Please join in. Thank you. Thank you, North Oakland Band and Annette. What a beautiful job you've done. This concludes our wonderful Veterans Day ceremony. Please help yourself to coffee, tea, and cookies in the bag. Have a wonderful weekend.